Welcome to another interesting video of Untold Discoveries. I hope you're doing great today. Archaeology had a massive 2024. Discoveries abounded, from ever-multiplying Pompei frescoes to dinosaur fossils in Iowa, as ancient histories continued to be rethought, fought over, and, in some cases, debunked. We bring you the year's 15 biggest archaeological finds, from the sewers of Rome to the deserts of Peru. But before we continue, please hit the like button, subscribe our channel with the bell icon, and share it with your circle. Number 15. A stone wall submerged in the Baltic Sea could be Europe's oldest megastructure, after traces of the subsequently named Blinker Wall showed up in high-resolution hydroacoustic imaging. A team of human divers went in for a closer look. Resting at more than 68 feet beneath the water's surface, the wall turned out to consist of about 1,400 small stones connecting 300 large boulders. This is the 3D model of a section of the Blinker Wall adjacent to the large boulder at the western end of the wall. The model was created using Agisoft Metashape by J. Auer. Number 14. Another Roman dodecahedron has been found. Because there are no surviving visual or textual references to dodecahedra, archaeologists can do little except speculate. Some believe that the objects may have functioned as measuring devices or calendars, while others think they were used as weapons or tools, possibly for knitting. Number 13. Remnants of a legendary typeface have been rescued from the River Thames. Green managed to recover a total of 151 sorts, the name for individual pieces of type, out of a possible 500,000. It's a tiny fraction, but when I was down by the river on my own, for one second it all felt very cosmic, he said. It was like Cobden Sanderson had dropped the type from the bridge and straight into my hands. Time just collapsed. Number 12, the final resting place of the first Roman emperor finally been found, alongside their quantitative data on the new site buried just beneath. Researchers observed remnants of a furnace likely used to heat a private bath, precisely the kind of amenity Augustus would have had. Carbon dating on matter left in the furnace showed it hadn't been used since the era of Augustus's death. The team also found a warehouse lined with shelves of ceramic amphora vessels, corroborating the temple function Augustus's villa later served. Number 11. Archaeologists discover a mysterious hidden structure near the Giza pyramids. They can already confirm that the structure is around 10 meters by 15 meters. At a depth of 0.5 to 2 meters, and is filled with homogeneous sand, suggesting it was filled in after its construction. Another anomaly has been found at a greater depth, which could indicate a tomb entrance leading to another chamber. Number 10. Overlooked hieroglyphics reveal this stone slab was part of Ramses II's sarcophagus. The latest discovery, the researchers added, offers further proof that the Valley of the Kings was not just subject to repeated looting, but that its funerary relics were often reused. For example, the tomb of Marenta, who succeeded Ramses II, was similarly robbed, with one of the sarcophagi recycled by Sassen's I for his own sumptuous tomb. Number 9. A marble god is found in an ancient Roman sewer. How did this artistic treasure end up in a sewer? The archaeologists believe it must have been put there for safekeeping sometime after 388 CE, when the city's infrastructure was devastated by an earthquake and the sewer became disused. Number 8. Construction workers in Rome discover Emperor Caligula's garden. The connection with Caligula, the first-century tyrant with a reputation for eccentricity and capriciousness, is offered through a lead water pipe stamped with the emperor's full name, Gaius Caesar Augustus Germanicus. His nickname means little boot and was bestowed for the miniature military footwear his father dressed him up in as a tyke. Number 7. Ancient Babylonian tablets are finally deciphered. They're full of bad news. The futures foretold were almost uniformly bad news for the empire, though some signaled destruction for Babylon's enemies. They range from inclement weather, with the warning the deluge will occur everywhere, to famine, as in people will trade their children for silver, there will be a reduction in population, to general chaos, cautioning there will be evil in the land, its bounty will disappear. Number 6. Ancient Peruvian site yields first ever throne room of a female ruler. The throne, which is built from painted adobe, directly faces the Pacific Ocean and stands in a room of walls and pillars marked with four scenes depicting a powerful woman. Researchers have named it the Hall of the Moche Imaginary on account of the fantastical painted vignettes that shed light on Moche beliefs and practices. Number 5. Researchers use AI to identify hundreds of mysterious ancient geoglyphs in Peru. With this tool, the researchers were able to discover 303 new figurative geoglyphs, doubling the number of known megaliths in the region. They report, in their study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, PNAS, in September 2024, that most of the geoglyphs depict humanoid figured, decapitated heads, and domesticated animals like llamas. Number 4, 2,000-year-old tomb found beneath Indiana Jones' filming location in Petra. The discovery of the tomb is being considered a breakthrough for research into the Nabataean nomadic culture, especially into their mysterious burial practices. Due to a lack of knowledge around these ancient customs, researchers are not sure which members of Nabataean society might have been buried in such a tomb. Number 3. An extravagantly decorated tiny house has been discovered in Pompei, one small home found to contain frescoes which rivaled even its most wealthy neighbors is being provisionally named the House of Phaedra after an excellently preserved fresco showing a scene from the ancient myth of Hippolytus and Phaedra. Other scenes painted onto the walls of the rear part of the House of Phaedra include an embrace between a nymph and a satyr, a couple thought to be Venus and Adonis, and a damaged mural showing the judgment of Paris. Number 2. First dinosaur fossils unearthed in Hong Kong make their museum debut, a first for Hong Kong, which has long been a center of paleontological research but had yet to witness a discovery on its own turf. The fossils have been put on display at the Hong Kong Heritage Discovery Center in Tsim Sha Tsui, one of the city's largest and busiest shopping districts, soon to be joined by a workshop where visitors can learn how fossils are preserved and studied. Number 1. New DNA testing of Pompeii victims just shattered long-held beliefs. The paper noted that these revelations show how modern assumptions about gendered behaviors may not be reliable lenses through which to view data from the past. Recent DNA testing of Pompeii victims has led to some fascinating discoveries that challenge long-held beliefs about the ancient city and its inhabitants. Key findings, gender, and relationships. DNA analysis has revealed that some individuals previously assumed to be women were actually men. This challenges previous assumptions about family structures and relationships within Pompeii. For example, a plaster cast depicting a man and child was long thought to be a mother and child, but DNA testing revealed the adult was male and not biologically related to the child. Diversity and origins. The study confirmed that Pompeii citizens came from diverse backgrounds, with many descending from Eastern Mediterranean immigrants. This highlights the city's cosmopolitan nature and the extensive trade and cultural exchange within the Roman Empire. Health conditions. DNA analysis can also provide insights into the health conditions of Pompeii residents. Researchers are investigating the presence of ancient diseases and their impact on the population. Overall, the new DNA testing of Pompeii victims is a significant development in our understanding of this ancient city. It challenges long-held beliefs, reveals new insights, and provides a more accurate and nuanced picture of the people who lived there. That's it for today. We will meet with another interesting topic very soon.